Forces of Chaos certainly have some amazing miniatures, and that's only got better recently with the addition of the new Maggoth Lord kit. Now, in this three-part series, I'm going to show you specifically how to paint Orgot's Demon Spew, although the techniques and advice I'm going to give you will be useful no matter which of the Maggoth Lords you happen to be doing, and they'll also be useful for any Warhammer monster, and even Warhammer 40,000 monster too. Now, in the first part, I'm going to show you how to paint the skin and the mouth of the creature, and in part two, I'll show you all the remaining details on the monster, so that's going to be things like the horns and the teeth and that sort of thing. And in part three, I'll show you how to do the rider and finish the whole model off. Now, as you're going to see, painting Nurgle miniatures is loads of fun, so go and grab your paints and we'll begin. Whatever model you're painting, it's usually best to start out with the main feature of it, and in this case it's going to be the skin of the monster. Now I'm going to be doing this dark green first of all, and as you can see, I've kept both the monster and the rider separate. Now, I recommend you do the same because doing this makes the painting process much easier. Now I've undercoated the model with Chaos Black Spray, and the first colour I'm going to use is Caliban Green. And as always, give your paints a good shake before you use them, and the brush you want to apply this is going to be a large dry brush, so that you can cover as much of the model as quick as possible. So I just need to load the brush up with some paint and then put it onto the palette. This is mainly to control how much paint's on the brush because you don't want to apply too much. If you put on too much at once, then you risk clogging detail. But this way, I can make sure I haven't got too much there, you see. And all you need to do for this first step is just start painting the skin with this dark green. Other details don't matter, so things like the teeth and the horns, it doesn't matter if you get any of this colour on them. You're just looking to work that colour into all those little details all over the flesh. So there we go, the first base coat is done. Now the next thing we're going to do is add another green, and this is to start the process of lightening the skin towards the monster's belly. So this colour you need is Deathworld Forest, and I'm going to be applying it using my large dry brush again. Now the application this time is a little bit different from what we've just done. You need to load up some innie brush, quite roughly, and what you're looking to do is paint this onto all the areas you want to have a lighter skin colour. So I'll start on his face, for example. I'm going to be painting it mainly around here. But when you're getting up close to the part where it transitions, notice that I'm starting to stipple it a bit more and being quite rough with it. Now, this will give quite a rough difference between the two colours here, just where it starts to transition, which is fine because this is just the first step of starting that blend for all the skin colours. So I'm going to carry on doing this around all the body now, following the inside, so the underside really, where the lighter colour is. Now, if you need a bit of guidance as to which bits to pick out for this, I recommend you follow the box picture. Just take your time working around the miniature. You might find you need to switch to a medium dry brush to get into some of the smaller areas down in underneath his belly down there. If you happen to go a bit too far with the Deathworld Forest, like I have just around here, then fixing it up's not a problem. Just go back to Caliban Green and just re-stipple over the top of it, just like that, and that'll fix that up, no problem. So now you can see with that stippling technique, the effect is already starting to happen. So the next thing to do is to add a third colour, and this is going to be Xandri Dust. Now the application for this is going to be, well, largely the same. You just need to be a little bit more focused about where you're applying this. So you just need to get your paint ready on your brush, not too much. It's best to apply this in moderation and build up. And, well, you'll start stippling this on. A bit more focused towards the underneath of the monster, so I'm going to be aiming a bit more towards the belly. So same application as before, but you're looking to have all three of these colours visible. So you see I've got the darker green, and I've got the mid one there, and then I've got this this lighter khaki colour down here. Now that all three base colours have been applied, the next thing to do is to add some shade to the miniature. Now the first of the shades I'm going to use is Nuln Oil, and I'm going to be applying this using my wash brush. And this is just to go around the very darkest areas of the skin. So that's going to be on the back, kind of around the spine, but also coming a little bit around the side of the body as well. So what I mean is to apply this mostly around the top. So I'm looking at areas like up here, but bringing it down up to about half a centimetre away from the transition from the darker green to the lighter green. Now when you're applying this, make sure you don't put it on too thickly so that it doesn't run out of control. Keep it thin like I'm doing here, and once you've applied it, give it plenty of time to dry. I've given the shade half an hour to dry, and now that it's set, we're ready to move on to the next shade, and this one's going to be Athonian Camo shade. Now the application for this is going to be very similar to what we've just done. It's just very important that you make sure you don't put on too much at once. So use your palette to get your shade ready, make sure you don't have too much on your brush, and then you start applying this onto the green areas. So I'm going to start on the darker green where I left off with the Nuln Oil. I'm just going to bring this colour down up to almost where that khaki starts. So just over the Deathworld Forest, just close to the bottom of it there. Now the reason why I'm keeping this thin is so that once it's dry, I don't get too stark of a line appearing between where the shade is here and where there's not any shade yet. But we'll pick up this shade later on with the next colour I will carry on going down all the way down the rest of the body. Now that the Ethonian camera shade's dried, you can see how it's given a nice smooth blend by bringing it up into the darker green areas here, whereas down here, because it's thin, I don't have a solid line between where the Ethonian camera shade is and the Zandri dust is. Now all that remains is to finish this effect, and for that you need Reichlin flesh shade. Now for this, I'm going to be applying it in the same kind of manner that I did with the Ethonian camera shade a moment ago. Just need to get some paint on your palette, make sure you haven't got too much on your brush again, and start applying this thinly. So I'm going to be painting this onto the Zandri dust areas, so down here, and I'm just going to bring it up to where that Ethonian camera shade led off. So just around about there, not any further, again keeping it thin. And once you've done this all over these lighter areas, you just need to give it plenty of time to dry. Now that I've finished those three different shades, you can see it's really brought all of the colours together on the skin. And all that remains now to do for the flesh is to highlight it. Now the first stage of highlighting the flesh is going to be with a technique called dry brushing, and for this you need Death Ward Forest and your large dry brush once again. And to do this technique, you just need to get a little bit of paint loaded on your brush, then get some tissue, and just start using the tissue to work the paint in amongst the bristles like this. Now doing this also gets rid of the excess paint, because you don't need very much on your brush for this. In fact, you want your brush to be looking kind of like that before you begin. And all you have to do is get your miniature and just very lightly start drawing the brush back and forth over the miniature. So around this detail around here, for example, on all the dark green areas, if I lightly brush it across there, you see that green catches on all the raised surfaces and really adds some nice highlighting very quickly and easily to the miniature. Now also notice that this colour I'm using is the same one that I used in the middle of the different skin colours here. So I only have to do this over the darker green areas, and as I get to those middle green areas, the colour will just disappear, and this really brings all those colours together nicely. Now when you're doing this, I really recommend you apply this colour in moderation and just gradually build it up as you go. It's much easier to add more colour than it is to take it away. With that dry brush complete, you can see it's really brought out all the texture around the back of the monster. And the next stage is to do, well, another dry brush really, but this time I'm going to be doing it using Zandri dust. Now the application is going to be much the same, but it's very important you make sure your brush is completely dry before you start getting your paint ready with this. You always need your brush to be dry when you're doing a dry brush, because if it's not, the paint can leave some streaky marks on the miniature. So just get your paint ready in the same way, once again not very much on your brush, and this time you're looking to apply this on the areas that you originally base coated with Death World Forest and Zandri dust. So I'm going to be lightly dry brushing around this kind of area here, and then bringing the paint down onto the lighter parts of the flesh, just like that, you see? And this will, once again, just bring all those colours together. Now I've finished that second dry brush, you can see we've got a really nice effect on the skin. And there's only one more colour to go to finish off the flesh. Now for this, you're going to need Ushabti bone, and I'm going to be applying this as well as a layer, so I'm going to be doing almost an edge highlight with it. Now you could do a dry brush if you wanted to, and if you decide to go that way, I recommend you use a medium dry brush to do this. But doing a highlight like this will give a sharper final result, which is what I want the skin to be like once it's done. Now I'm using my fine detail brush for this, and I'm going to use my palette to help control the paint. I'm going to add a little bit of water into there, just to thin the paint down. This will help it flow smoother onto the miniature. And I'm going to use the palette by dragging my brush and twisting it to bring my bristles to a nice fine point. And this will give me the most control I can get over the brush. And what I'm looking to do here is paint thin lines and all the wrinkles, and also a bit of colour on the top of these boils just to pick them out as well. So don't need very much, just a little bit like this. And doing this really brings out all those details around the face, well, around this mouth. So I'm going to do this now around this mouth and of course the one on the belly as well. And once this is done, the flesh will be complete. So there we go, with that highlight, the bulk of the flesh is now complete. There are still things like boils and pustules and wounds and stuff to do, but we're going to come back to those later on. The next thing we're going to be painting is going to be the tongue and the mouths. Now for this, the first colour you're going to need is Screamer Pink, and I'm going to be using a large brush to apply this. And this is just a base coat to get this area started. So I get a good amount of the paint on the palette, and I'm going to thin it down with a little bit of water again, like before, just to help with the paint and help it flow smoother onto the model. A good amount loaded on your brush, and you're just looking at this stage to paint all the areas that you want to be kind of this pinkish colour for the gums. So I'm going to be doing all the tongue, so all around here, and also all the interior of the mouth. As for around the mouth, around here, I'm just going to be painting around here up to the edge where the gums finish. Now, there are the teeth here that I'm painting over, obviously, but that's not a problem because I'm going to be coming back to the teeth later. So for this stage, you're just looking to get a good even base coat around all these areas. Now with that base coat done, I've got a really good starting point for all the other colours around the mouth. And the next thing is going to be actually to paint around the edge of the maw. Now for doing this, I'm going to be doing a mix. I'm going to be mixing Caraberg Crimson with Lamium Medium, and this is going to be a one-to-one mix. Now the reason why I'm using Lamium Medium rather than water is because this allows me to dilute a paint without changing its properties. So when it dries, it's still going to dry smoothly. If I used water in the same way, the paint would start to dry a bit kind of rough looking. So Lamium Medium is going to give us a much better finish for this. Now, whenever you're using the medium, remember to make sure that you don't contaminate it with any other colours. So I'm going to get some of that on my palette first of all, then get an equal amount of Caraberg Crimson, and just mix those together. Now, the trick here is to make sure that you don't apply too much at once. So I'm going to use my palette here to get rid of any excess shade, and I'm looking at having around about that much loaded on my brush. And what I'm going to do is start painting this around the edge of the maw. So I'm going to be going around these sort of pustule things around here, kind of about that far. See, it's not too strong at this point, it's quite subtle, just perfect for this first stage. And when you get to the edge of that area, what you need to do is get some tissue and use this just to get rid of the excess. And then when you go back to your model, use the dry brush now just to bring that mix a bit further out. And this gives a really smooth blend towards the edge of the maw. So what you need to do now is do this around all the way around both mouths and also these little horrible bits that are kind of hanging down from underneath here. With that first shade done, you can see how it's just reddened around the maw now, and it makes him look kind of sore and painful, doesn't it? The next stage is to apply another shade. This time it's just going to be Caraberg Crimson on its own, and I'm going to be applying it using my wash brush this time. And, well, when you get your paint ready, make sure you don't have too much on your brush, just so it doesn't start running everywhere and getting on all that skin that you painted already. But get a good amount loaded on your brush. So once you're ready, what you're looking to do this time is paint it all over the areas you'd scream a pink earlier on. So that's going to be things like all of his tongue, all the inside of the mouth, and also when you get to the edge of the maw, just go a little bit around that edge of the skin, so just along there, and that's just to make it red just on the very edge of the flesh, around where the mouth begins. I've given the shade about 20 minutes to dry, and now that that's done, we're ready to add some highlights to the tongue. Now from this point on you don't really need to worry about the interior of the mouth anymore because, well, it's full of teeth, but the tongue is the focus for this point. And the first colour you need is Pink Horror. Now this colour I'm going to be applying using my standard brush, and you just need to, well, once again, use your palette to thin your paint down with a little bit of water and use it to get that good tip on your brush. You don't need a lot of paint on your brush at this point. And when you're ready, what you need to do is, well, pick one side of the tongue. I'm going to start on this side, and you're looking to paint as line as neatly as you can, following it all the way around. So just along here, I'm going to keep my hands as steady as possible and just start running the colour all the way around. And once I've done this all the way around this side, I'm going to do exactly the same on the opposite side. Once the first highlight's done, you can add a second one to really accentuate the shape of that tongue, really bring out the curves on it. And for this, the colour you need is a Shabti Bone, and I'm going to apply this one using my fine detail brush, because this one you need to be more in control of. Once you've got your paint ready on your palette, I'll just, you know, thin it down and get a good tip on your brush. Once the paint's ready, this you're looking to just paint just on the curves. So get that good tip on the brush. And you're painting it just on areas like around the top here. So get your hands as steady as possible and just paint a thin line just on these areas like I'm doing here, to about that kind of distance on that side. And about there on that side. And you see that really just starts to define that shape. Now also, whilst you're doing this stage, you just need to paint these kind of blobs of poison, these little bits here with a Shabti Bone as well. And this is to prepare them for the next step, where we're going to get a really horrible greenish tint to those. Now the tongue's fully highlighted, the next thing to do is to add some green to all that poisonous slime dripping from the tongue. Now for this, the colour you need is Nurgle's Rot, and I'm going to apply it using a standard brush. Now this is, well, it's very straightforward doing this part. You just need to get some of the paint ready. You don't need to thin this down at all. Just get some loaded on your brush, and it's as simple as just painting this onto all those goops of slime down here. So just start painting it over. This will give it a really horrible greenish tinge, just like that. Now you might need to add a second coat to this to build up the green if you want it to be stronger, but whilst you're doing this, don't forget to get them all. There are some that are in his mouth, and there's also one in his stinger on his back as well. With the Nurgle's Rot done, there's only one more thing to do to finish off the tongue and the mouth, and that is going to be to apply some Ardcoat varnish over the whole thing. This will give it a really kind of like a horrible, wet, shiny appearance. So all you need to do is use your large brush for this, get your paint ready on your palette. And this you don't really need to thin down, you just need to get a good amount loaded on your brush, and I'm just going to paint this over all the parts I've been doing for the mouth and the tongue as well, of course. And this, you see, gives it a wet shine. Now, it doesn't matter if you get this on the Nurgle's Rock, because that's shiny anyway, or the teeth, in fact, because we're going to be painting the teeth later on anyway. So there we go. With that hard coat down, you can see that a huge amount of this model is now done. And in fact, the toughest part is behind us with that three-tone skin. And as you've seen, doing it is really not that difficult to get a great result. Now, when you're painting this stage of your Maggoth beast, and in fact with any monster, it's a good idea to do those first base colours quite roughly. Remember that stippling motion I was doing? This helps start to blend the colours together. Now, after you've done that, use shades and then dry brushing to really help bind those colours together. But it's important that when you're applying them, you do them in moderation. You can always add more if you need to, but it's much harder to take them away. Now, this part is done. We're going to move on to part two, where I'm going to show you how to paint all the remaining details in the monster. That's going to be things like the horns and the teeth and all the pustules and all the final bits as well. So I'll see you in part two.